What you're looking at right now is one of the most mysterious and intensely studied artifact in human history. It's a 14.5 feet long and 3.5 feet wide ancient linen cloth, and it's filled with patches of burnt holes and watermarks. And in between that, there's a faint image of a man covered with bloodstains. And many believe it to be the linen cloth bought by Joseph of Arimathea to cover Jesus after his crucifixion. And these burnt holes are from a fire accident in 1532 when it was preserved in Léry, France. Within few years, it moved to a cathedral in Turin, Italy, where it remained since then. And no one knew its existence except for the locals. And in 1898, when an Italian photographer named Secondo Pia was allowed to take the first photograph of the shroud, he made a startling discovery when he developed the image into negative. And it was for the first time in history we were able to see the hidden image on the shroud, which is invisible to the naked eye. And the mystery of the image caught up with many scientists, and over the years there were hundreds and hundreds of studies done on this cloth, making it the single most studied artifact in human history.
Shroud of Turin. Is it the burial cloth that covered Jesus Christ when his crucified body was laid in the tomb?
If it is a fake, why can't anyone work out how it was made or recreate its ghostly image?
Mystery is unquestionably the most sensitive, controversial, and emotional enigma in the world today.
In 1976, a group of scientists at Sandio Laboratories uses VP8 image analyzer to evaluate X-rays. So it's an analog video processing device that converts image density into vertical relief. In other words, it gives a three-dimensional brightness map where if it sees something bright, it comes up, and if it sees something dark, it goes down. This is Dr. John Jackson, who was a captain of the Air Force Weapons Laboratories, who was also interested in the shroud image and its uniqueness. So when he got access to the VP8 image analyzer through Bill Matton in Sandio Laboratories, they placed a photograph of the shroud under the camera to examine it, and this is what they saw. What they found out was that the shroud gave a natural relief of a human, which means the height of the nose, cheeks, and other parts of the body are proportional to the brightness of the image. And this kind of property is not found in any painting or photographs. For example, in this photograph, you can see the one side of the face, the nose, and other parts of the face are out of proportion. This is because the brightness of a photograph is determined by the lights and the shadows, and not by depth as we see in the shroud. The shroud has a well-documented history all the way back to the 14th century, when Geoffrey de Charny displayed in Léry, France. That's like 500 years before the invention of photography. So we have an ancient cloth with frontal and dorsal image of a man, in which the lights and darks are reversed and has this astonishing three-dimensional property to it. And we don't have anything like this in the history of humanity. So Dr. John Jackson and his colleague Eric Jumper shared their findings with the other scientists. So within few months, the Shroud of Turin research project was formed, with over 30 scientists from various laboratories like the Los Alamos, NASA's Jet Propulsion Lab, and other prestigious places. And they spent over 18 months preparing a series of tests that would gather vast amount of data from the shroud. And the church also gave them 5 days around the clock to examine the shroud. So it was well over 120 hours of non-destructive research, with a variety of tests ranging from X-rays to infrared to chemical and medical analysis. And in the late September, the STIRP team fled to Italy. There were Italian scientists and Swiss scientists who joined the examination, and they worked day and night examining the shroud with all these high-tech instruments and photographs. After 5 days and 3 years of data analysis, which has been published in well-known peer-reviewed scientific journals, the STIRP team concluded the shroud is not a work of an artist, that there is no pigment like paint, dye, powder, or anything like that would possibly cause the image. And the image is so superficial as it appears only on the top 3 microfibers of a thread. And each microfibers are about the diameter of a human hair. So in a thread, there are about 200 microfibrils, in which only the top 3 microfibrils carry the image, which makes it physically impossible for any artist to paint at this level of superficiality. And the image is formed due to a molecular modification of the surface linen fibrils, where single covalent bonds are turned into double covalent bonds. So it is a conjugated dehydrated cellulose that carries the image. And this is a photomicrograph of the nose region, one of the darkest areas of the image, where you can see the microfibrils are not cemented together with any paint or binder. So it is the molecularly modified linen fibrils that make up the image which we see on the shroud today. We don't know what caused this modification, but there are speculations that radiation could be a possible candidate for the image formation. And this Italian scientist demonstrated that ultra-short UV laser impulses can create image on linen with similar microscopic properties to the shroud. But the problem is, we don't have the technology to replicate a life-size image like the shroud. As we saw on that VP8 image analyzer, the intensity of the image varies with the distance of the body to the cloth, and it gave enough data to make 3D models and sculptures out of it. And there is no well-defined borders as you would see in a painting. And you can see the image is also formed on the non-contact regions. For example, between the cheeks and the nose, the eyes, the neck region, and etc. Due to gravity, our instinct would suggest that the back image to be denser than the front. Surprisingly, the density of the front and the back image is the same, which indicates that the weight of the body or gravity doesn't affect the image formation. So to acquire these properties, we need a mechanism that can travel through space and chemically modify only the topmost linen fibrils with varying intensity on the body to cloth distance in high definition.
That it's not nearly as simple as you think. You can look at it and say, well, that's just a simple image, but it's probably the most complex image I've seen in my 50-year career.
This is Barry Schwartz. He was the official documenting photographer of the STIRP team and one of the leading experts on the shroud. And for the last couple of decades, scientists have put forward dozens of naturalistic hypotheses to explain the image formation, but none of them can truly explain how the image was formed onto the cloth. Scientists have tried replicating the shroud with different artistic techniques like the bas relief, frottage, photographs, and several others. And they got some visually similar results. But when it comes to its chemical and physical properties, they're no way close to it.
Look, in 78, our goal was what? To answer the question, how's the image formed? Well, we couldn't really answer that question. We didn't come back with an answer to that. But we can tell you what it's not. We've proven, first time you've heard me use the word today, we've proven it's not a painting. We've proven it's not a scorch. Sorry, Joe Nickel. And we've proven that it's not a photographically made image, particularly by Leonardo da Vinci, as some people have claimed. Da Vinci was a great artist, but the shroud was being publicly shown 100 years before da Vinci was born. He wasn't that good. So I hear all these things. But the peer-reviewed published science proves it's neither of those three. What's left? We don't know.
If the most advanced technologies available in the 21st century could not produce a facsimile of the shroud image, how could it have been executed by a medieval forger?